In this video, I'll talk about the $471 monthly SSI benefit and how much it would rise if the marital penalty for supplemental security income were eliminated. Let's talk about what's going on, and I have all those details for you in this video. I'm now limited to discussing SSI, supplemental security income, and the approximately 8 million recipients who receive these benefits each month from Social Security in this video. But I do want to draw your attention to the present benefit levels as of right now, as well as the main topic of the film is the possible elimination of the marriage penalty and what it would mean for the millions of people who already get benefits, but have had their benefits reduced once more as a result of the far too long-standing law. Let's get started and discuss what's going on here. I get inquiries about this fairly frequently, and I want to break it all down so you can see the numbers behind this as well as what it means for your monthly benefits. But before we do, I would really like to ask for a great favor from you. If you haven't already, please join the chat room. I sincerely appreciate your participation. I'm here for you every single day, talking to the details, watching the headlines, and arguing on behalf of the other nearly 500,000 people on the channel. Please click the subscribe button directly below the video to show your appreciation. There are many various things out there when it comes to these fixed income benefits, so I'm happy to answer any questions I can for you right now and break down all of the fine aspects of Social Security and all the programs run by the program. Be really confused, but don't worry, I'm here to support you every day. Please subscribe below and share the video with your friends on social media. There's a share button right there. Thank you very much, and let's speak about... Okay, so let's talk about the infamous marriage penalty. Who came up with this law and why is it so bad? Let's be serious for a moment. Really? Who is the legislator that came up with this notion like, hey, this program should be started, but before it can do its work, some ludicrous marriage penalty clause should be included, reducing benefits for married individuals? About you, I'm not sure, but that simply seems so strange and depressing to me. Since this program has been in place for far too long and has a clause that limits benefits for married individuals due to marital penalties, it is sad that many people are affected by it. Why would they include such a thing in it? That get SSI benefits, or those I want to marry, but don't, since their income will drastically decrease and they'll have to pay a penalty, which isn't a good situation. Nevertheless, you are aware of the specifics, so let me explain. I want to share the figures with you as soon as possible so you can understand exactly what's going on and how much benefits are actually decreased on a monthly basis due to the so-called marital penalty. All right, so obviously, I'm in. As I recorded this video in 2024, the maximum benefit for an individual was $943. You are aware that the maximum benefit for a married couple is, once more, $1,415. You are undoubtedly aware of this. Now, let's see how this works out. As an individual, you receive $943, as you might expect. A married pair and two individuals, you simply increase the gain by twofold, correct? You would obtain $1,886 if you took $943*2. That is untrue. As a married couple, you are qualified to receive up to $1,415, the highest amount that may be awarded to a married pair. Doesn't really make sense, but this is how it works out. All right, so here's the math. For an individual, you get 150% of the monthly benefit, or $1,415. That's all there is to it. It's basically 150% of the maximum individual benefit. Resolve the marriage. Okay, so that's precisely what that turns out to be the biggest benefit for a married couple. So, to put it this way, imagine this. You go to your favorite store, which happens to be your local store, and you see a buy one get one 50% off deal at the sales counter or in the clearance department. This is essentially the same way as when it comes to SSI, where one beneficiary is paid for in full and the other arrives in at a 50% level, which is essentially the same thing. It's similar to a buy one, get one 50% off kind of deal. That's how SSI benefits work. The first beneficiary receives 100%, and they can be eligible for up to 100% of the individual benefit, 943, with the remaining one being roughly 50% of that. That's how it turns out. I realize it's an odd analogy, but it's a simple approach to think about it and gain a better understanding of the reasoning behind this. The marriage penalty results in a monthly difference of $471. Well, that's what the math says, so let's go back to where the benefits are at the moment. Currently, a married couple's maximum benefit is $1,415 per month if the marriage penalty is applicable. Was eliminated, and both individuals qualified for the maximum benefit of $943 per month, or $1,886 for married couples. This means that, as a result of the marriage penalty, there was a $471 monthly difference. Turn out to be, so when you read about the marriage penalty or experience it yourself as an SSI recipient, consider this. If you are receiving a lower benefit due to your marital status, consider this. It's a $471 monthly penalty. Cost that comes with being married, so consider it that way. That's kind of screwed up. I'm not sure how to phrase it correctly, but that's the arithmetic. By the way, that comes out to $471 annually on an annualized basis. Let me fast do the math on that. I didn't do it before I started this, but I'm just kind of interested because I have my phone sitting here. A month is roughly $5,600 a year. Here, I'm just going to ask my phone real quick. All right, so 471 times 12 is 5,652, which means I wasn't too far off. That's a huge amount of money. So basically, the marriage potential penalties for SSI beneficiaries might be costly because you must also determine whether you qualify for the maximum benefit, which varies depending on the individual, but that's how things work out. So I'm placing my return the call there. It turns out that beneficiaries of the marriage penalty are literally paying up to $471 each month for it, or as you heard me say on my phone, $5,600 when I did the math. What was spoken there? $52 or $56 a month, or roughly that. That works out to be $565 a month, which is insane and a lot of money. Or, to correct myself, I meant to say $565 a year, which is how much money that ends up being. Of money, which is a significant amount of money for a fixed-income couple living on SSI. All right, so this illustrates the extent of the marriage penalty. How many SSI recipients are married, and hence eligible for this reduction, is a really good question. To be completely honest, I don't know the exact number at this time, but I do know that a significant amount of people in this community are going through this, since I can see from your comments below that there are the inquiries that constantly come in asking, "Hey, did they do anything about the marriage penalty yet?" Down the chat box for live streaming is located below in the comment area. This question about the marriage penalty comes up frequently. I do know that many of you here in the community are asking, did they ever remove this dreadful penalty? Unfortunately, it's still there as of now. But again, I just want to bring it up. Frequently enough where you know what it's worth talking about every now and then. Bringing this to your notice as soon as possible. I believe I have made this rather apparent in the video thus far, but I still want to bring it to your attention. No, the penalty has not been eliminated. It is still in place. Focus so you can easily understand the math involved and the financial implications of how much this monthly beneficial series is costing. The maximum monthly payment of $471 up to that amount, or up to $565 annually, is how much this is currently affecting beneficiaries. Again, that's only if beneficiaries were receiving the maximum amount in 2024. That is, if the marriage penalty was eliminated and beneficiaries were receiving the maximum amount. But even so, that's still a significant amount of money. Hundreds of dollars, no matter how you slice it. A month and thousands of dollars annually. That's big money, and for many people, money that changes their lives, right?